Cause you talk love, but you never.
What number is too happy?
From female?
Yeah.
You hitting to me is double digits.
If you had a
cold 9, we can still convert. Like you said, we first came into it though, right? So everybody goes through that phase. You feel me? And primarily for dudes, I'll be honest, it usually happens between that 17, I say about 21 phase. Because you're just not getting old enough to start going to clubs. You just not starting to get to the point where you can actually go to like drink and everything like that. You go on house parties and stuff like that. So 9 times out of 10, you hitting puberty, you ready to just go ahead and right. just bang anything.
And from women, you know what I'm saying, my study proves that once y'all get y'all
what study with?
That's when y'all go through y'all old phase. As soon as that first dude breaks your heart, that's when y'all go
right. That's what. So it either, and at that point, either, well, hold on, because that's my experience. At that point, it either goes one or two ways. That's a decision tree, right? So once that first heartbreak happens, you either go down that path where you like, man, you know what? I'm holding out until I find Mr. Right. I'm gonna find my knight in shining armor. We're gonna figure something
out. Or you turn into
oh, you know what I'm saying? I'm
fuck these niggas.
Shame you, let's go.
Y'all keep thinking of the whole phase. Y'all keep thinking of the puberty. I'm just going out experiment. You're still missing the point that people can have relationships with 10 people for a while, be committed, and it not work out. If we're all 25, 26, you could be in a serious relationship and 10 times right about now.
How long do relationships last, though?
As a serious relationship, that's the question.
If we're exclusive, that's why I'm not talking to no one.
Exactly,
else,
that's serious.
You don't even have to have the title, but if I say I'm not messing with anyone else and you're not messing with anyone else,
it's a serious relationship.
We're in a relationship because that a physical relationship for damn sure. Because I'm saying I'm not messing with anyone else, so that means you aren't messing with anyone else. And if we have that understanding,
that means I'm
kissing. It could last 6 months. And it can last 3 years. And it's really up to the two people.
See, guys, it's really different. It's a difference.
That's 10 guys you can get a relationship to. I'm kissing 10 dudes every time I kiss you.
We kissing 30 girls!
But I'm not.
But that's how
I know, man.
That's how women are like, hey, when we gonna be in a relationship? Hey, what's next? Because we don't want to waste our time. And if we give it up, we really like, so, where's your mind at? Where you at? Because it's like, y'all are always thinking if we add our numbers, that's not the one.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So we have that. That's the question we're going to have.
We want to be committed, and if we don't, we thoughts. We can't be.
You can't be too good. You can't be too bad.
You're the 6 month rule, okay? And guys will respect you.
No, that's the thing.
As a young woman, yeah, I had an
initial body count of what was too much, and it's all because of what I thought my future husband would accept, and it's because of what a man thinks, and that's ridiculous. We should not have that as women. If you want to mess with someone because you like them and you're vibing with them, why not? Why do we have to think about something that we, that's hypothetical?
Eli, why are we here today?
A hypothetical man we don't even know about.
Are we here for double standards? I think we all acknowledge that that's a double standard.
It is what it is.
But we're saying, like, how can we? Why?
Why? Because we feel that if you guys have intercourse with multiple dudes to the double digit.
Why is it all about y'all feeling?
Right.
Exactly.
Because
you gave us this power.
No, I didn't.
Jordan with the little tips on his body. You feel me? We are, that shows you done made it through. That's the rank. You know what I'm saying? We done made it.
That's
when you're younger, hold on. When you're younger, when you get older, you can't undo those body counts. You can't undo what you did in the past. All you can do at that point is just be like, okay, when I have that epiphany and that mindset that says, hey, you know what? From here on out, all that stuff that you did before, that was cool, bro. You had fun, you experimented, you may have dodged a couple of situations that you know what I'm saying could have been in. But going forward, you know what I'm saying? Now you understand that, hey, you know what? My body count is actually important to me. I can't undo the 50, 60 that I had before.
Yeah, so why but you what I can like do, that with the woman you dating? So why you can't 50, forgive 60? Her for her pain? Like,
right. You her if they had that younger age, they had that younger mentality.
Okay, what's the other aspect of
it? I mean, I don't know. You tell me. What else you looking for? Like, just because she has a body count, like, that's petty to me.
The thing that bothers me is that when we talk about the men, it's just like, oh, we go through this phase, we got puberty, we got all this stuff that we go through, that we got all these body counts. When it comes down to a woman, we got 20. You don't look at, oh, she was a young woman, she was going through things. Y'all don't mention that when we talk about the women, but you mention that when we talk about the men.
You don't think we have a weighted average? It's like, y'all have a weighted average? Body brown, your team Mac, or your team all natural, you know what I'm saying? What's up?
She's the man allowed.
would have a side piece and he was wanting to say cool with it, would you have a side piece?
No. Because I don't want him to have a side piece.
Right, exactly.
Hold on, hold on.
Not only that, though, like, why are you married? Why are you married? If you want to go ahead and have a side piece, why don't you just be single? Like, I don't understand that.
So what about open marriage?
Are we
talking about like
marriage?
Exactly.
We're talking about open marriage. In general.
Yeah, you're married, so you go on and get a lot right there. Yeah. Unless it's open marriage.
Now, I know somebody who's dating right now, and they're both okay with
having side
doing their own.
That's up to them.
So that seems like when they get married, they're going to agree on the same thing. You can't just ask me randomly. You go through the whole relationship, being faithful, and then 5 years in, like, so, hey.
What if we cheat because we love you, everything is good, but y'all don't give it up enough, so we go in.
That doesn't make it okay.
Yeah. Communication. That's what Pornhub is for. That's what it's for.
Communication.
So y'all expect us to self-medicate when y'all don't want to
do it. So is it okay?
We ain't talking about that. If you're saying that she's not doing anything, we're talking about
in general a side piece.
Why do you think we have side pieces?
Once you get to that point where the smashes start slacking, that's when the dude is going to go ahead and start looking out. Because in his mind, when we first started our relationship, that's what we had. So if you don't have, but hold on, if you have the communication at the very beginning, when you have those low moments where your smashing ain't there, you're not thinking, as a dude, you're not thinking, I need to go out here and find me something. Why? Because at that point, I've already invested so much time into this female. And if you got kids, to your point, I'm not about to sit here and risk child support. I'm not about to risk my house. I'm not about to risk my car. You know what I'm saying? I can go out and see.
I can go out and see all that. You haven't even gotten that far. Because let's say you're dating, and I had to tell him, we don't have this problem, but I had to tell him, like, when we were long distance, of course, like, I'm chilling. My house ain't perfect. I ain't got to cook meals for you. I have to do all these responsibilities. Right. But then when you come into town, I'd be like, oh, the house clean.
Exactly.
Dinner ready. Right. I didn't put on this grunt because you're here. So when you're dating, you're not doing all the same things because you're not living together. Then when you live together, there's a different standard. You right. want, you got to cook for him. You have to clean for him because you don't want his mama to be like, look at this dirty
ass.
You ain't
feeding
my baby.
So they not even married yet. Not everybody cook for their man.
Okay? That had to mean that there was already some kind of connection there. That's what I'm saying. That goes back to what I was saying.
And to his point,
when you start off with communication and that connection already there, when you get older and that lack starts to happen, you're already thinking in your mind. That's not even a thought to go out and do whatever, because you know you don't want to sacrifice. That's what I'm saying. No, I mean, I understand, but you know what I'm saying?
And she got my baby over.
Now, here's my question.
It's a lot of niggas like that.
Why y'all change the game? When y'all first start in a relationship with a dude, y'all doing all this little freaky, crazy stuff. Y'all doing all the little cooking, whatever. But as soon as the relationship get deep, y'all start changing the game. Y'all don't wear Bobby Brown no more. Y'all get that dollar store makeup. Y'all be like,
I think it works on both ends. We both need to put in effort.
Okay, so if you're talking about dating over a course of years, hell, I grow up. I've become a different woman than when you first started dating.
You still need a baby leg. You know what I'm saying? I don't understand.
So, I'm not the 20-whatever-year-old that I was. I'm now a grown woman. I have a real-ass job that requires more time, more mental space. I don't have time to be dealing with your ass all the damn time.
Hey. You make time for what you want.
You do, but at the same time, so do you.
You do, but
so if you feel like y'all are like Rocky, you need to make some time for that. You know what I'm saying?
But like, every day? Every day.
See, that's what it calls for, yeah. Like,
y'all call it every day.
Okay. Hey, Eli, how many times a week should you take care of your man?
What do you mean?
Sexually? Yeah, duh.
Well, you can put out about stuff.
Speaking, I guess, in sexual terms, is that's what we kind of talk about. So, how many times do we need?
Like, you mess it up and we put a number on it.
Yeah. Because I feel like most of these, like, all right,
oh, it's cool.
Three or four.
Oh, yeah.
So, I'm like, that's like.
Sometimes you want to hit it with the long stroke. Sometimes you want to hit it with just the jackrabbit. You know what I'm saying? So, if that's the case, four times I feel like it's still going to work. Every once in a time, okay, you want to hit it with one of these.
You're on a break day.
It's not like you had a week.
It definitely need to be the Friday, Saturday week.
That's what I'm saying. Sometimes
you got two days.
Y'all making kids to Jamaica.
I ain't lying. That's very in the relationship, though. Like, they don't care if it's like you can't, because I know some dudes out here doing that shit too. You know what I'm saying? They picking up straight from the daycare. They taking their kid all over the city. You know what
they're
what
coaching the basketball team.
You know, like, little Johnny, little Timmy, and Toby in the back seat.
Exactly.
In the back seat. You know what I'm saying?
Like, straight. And they still got
Toby. You tell me all the time, baby. Love me more each day.